The chair now recognizes the gentleman from the great state of Indiana, Mr. Pence, for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Chairman Rush and Ranking Member Upton, for holding this hearing, and thank you, Assistant Secretary Hoffman, for being with us today. You know, as the head of the Office of Electricity, you play a key role in advancing grid modernization efforts that could benefit the Hoosiers in my Indiana 6th District, where we have coal, natural gas, wind, and solar. Modernizing our transmission system for the 21st century isn't a partisan issue, and I'm all of the above type of individual. However, the self-imposed timeliness, as you've heard today, of the Clean Future Act and the administration commitments, in my opinion, are unworkable, unrealistic, and may be incredibly costly. Earlier this year, I had the opportunity to sit down with Ms. Miso, I think which you mentioned earlier, in Carmel, Indiana. In their estimation, by 2030, ensuring reliability and affordability, generation mix in the region could be 32% renewable energy and 55% fossil fuels. In other words, the lead entity ensuring reliability in my grid does not find it feasible to meet the administration's goal of carbon-free power by 2035 and the stringent timeline of the Democrats' clean energy standards. Our grid has taken over a century and a half to build, but some of my colleagues are talking about replicating this network in a mere 15 years. We should be supporting private industry stakeholders across the country that are already investing to bring our shared goal into reality. In fact, just in Indiana, the utilities across my state have invested over $2 billion annually to upgrade transmission and smart grid capabilities. There needs to be a landing strip for this committee to work together on modernizing our grid. This can be done by leveraging private investment into transmission technologies and maintaining local authority, which I, like my fellow Hoosier Congressman Bashan has pointed out, that's a big deal in putting windmills and solar panels. It's just people have fought back at that tooth and nail. Pressuring utilities to meet unrealistic timeliness will only sacrifice reliability and will most likely lead to steep increases in electricity prices for my ratepayers and probably higher taxes. I wish my colleagues would support efforts to streamline permitting and construction costs to leverage private investment without superseding local authority. The ambitious timeliness to integrate renewable energy into our grid rely too heavily on technology that, in my opinion, is not ready to provide sufficient service at a cost that is reasonable. You know, earlier you talked about technologies that would deliver to retail. I know that some of the things that are happening in Europe, delivering charging stations, the locations have to spend, in some cases, millions of dollars to be able to put in the grid stations. And I suggest that you take a look at that, and I'd be happy to help with that information. As one example, you already know modernized grids will need to provide dispatchable, flexible energy supply to make up for the variability of wind and solar. However, current battery storage technologies are not yet ready to provide more than a short-term backstop. Here's my question, Assistant Secretary Hoffman. Can you talk about some of the successful grid modernization R&D initiatives that the tools you mentioned earlier have helped the private sector to develop economic alternatives to achieve this administration's timeline?
So thank you, Congressman, for the question. Through the Grid Modernization Initiative, we've really been working on developing advanced technologies and capabilities in support of the utility sector. And some of the things that we've looked at is sensors for asset management to improve the utilization of the electric grid. And so some of the...
If I may, just specifically, I'm running out of time. So have Has private industry implemented some of those things you have developed or recommended?
Congressman, yes.
Okay, thank you. And Mr. Chair, I'll yield back. Thank you.